Let us see the next topic of rules of naming of the complex compounds. In this first ionic complex, the cation, whether it is a complex or not, to be written a first acid, and then only we should write an anion is named second. So for example, first you have taken a square bracket and here it is taken as a counter ion. Second only is the square bracket. If the square bracket comes first, this is considered as a cation. If the counter ion is come, it is called as a cation. Next square, second square bracket come, it is called as a anion. So this is cation, this is anion. For this case, this is cation and this full square bracket is an anion. When you remove one Cl minus, it acquires plus one. When you remove three potassium, it acquires three minus. Like that, we can say the charges. That is another matter. But we are considered the first, whichever comes, whether square bracket comes or a counter ion comes, we should give first priority to the first one. This is square bracket has come as a first, so it is considered as a cation. And this is considered a counter ion to be considered as a cation. Second one to be considered as an anion, whether square bracket or if it is a counter ion. Now it is a diamine. This is neutral ligand. Two is comes, so it is a diamine. This is a only one Cl outside. This is Ag. Oxidation status plus one. So it is a silver, Roman letter one, enclosed in a close bracket and then chloride. Next, first we should say potassium. Cation should say first. Next one is comes to the square bracket. So in this square bracket, start from the right to left naming. So ligand. Six ligand means X. This is cyanido. This is cyanido. Carbon is the donor atom. So we should write KC. So it is that difference between this and three. Generally, we can say find difference of this and this three. So that oxidation state is plus three. So to be written in a Roman letters, the Roman letter three. It is Roman letter three. That is if it, this is anion. Anionic complex means central metal ion to be ended with the eight. So what ferrate? It is a some Greek Latin names are changed now. So for iron, it is called a ferrate. If it is a silver, means it is argentate. So stannous, tin means stannate, and lead means what? Plumbate, copper means cuprate, gold means aurate. Like that, they will change the name. So what it is the anionic complex, it should be ended by 8. So ferrate. So potassium, I have written first. Then come across this square bracket, hexa. Cyanido, hexacyanido. This is donation of the carbon. So it is KC. It is an anionic complex. So it is a 8 to be ended by the 8. So ferrate, Roman letter 3. Then naming of the complex. Once again, I'm repeating K3 within a square bracket, FeCN6. For first, we should say cation, that is potassium. And then ligand, square bracket. We should start from the ligands to central metal. So ligand is 6-6 cyanido. That cyanido, that carbon is a donor. So we should write a KC. Cyanido, KC. Then this is anionic complex. So that the central metal ion to be ended by 8. In Greek, that is the ion is ferrate. So what it is a ferrate, Roman letter 3, enclosed in close bracket. Naming of the complex ion. First, we should say the number. Whether di or tri like that. Then name of the ligand given first and then the central metal atom followed by its oxidation state. This is the arrangement. For example, Ag, NH3 twice, Cl. So this is di. So number di, tri, tetra, penta, like that number to be said di. And then the it is a name the ligand. This ligand is called amine. So name of the ligand is amine. Then third one is central metal atom, that is silver. Then oxidation state, it is plus one valency to be written in a Roman letters enclosed in a close bracket, that is Roman letter one. This is oxidation state of the central metal atom of silver plus one to be written as a Roman letter one. So first we should give number of the ligand, and then name of the ligand, and then central metal atom, then oxidation state to be mentioned in aroma letters. So diamine, silver, aroma letter 1. Then last counter ion should say as a chloride. Right? Then name of the ligands end in O. Already I told you. Again I'm repeating and recalling the points. IDE, IDO. ITE, ITO. ATE, ATO. So E is replaced by the suffix of O. So negative ligands end in O. So water, the chloride is called chlorido. Bromide is called bromido. Iodide is called iodido. Cyanide is called cyanido. So here the ampidentate ligand use a K term, constant term. So constantly we are using same name for a cyanide as well as isocyanide. So cyanide is called cyanido, isocyanide also is called cyanido. But this is CNL, cyanido, KC, this is also called as cyanido common name. Commonly we can call it as a cyanido, KN. Then thiocyanate, thiocyanate 2. I mean isothiocyanate 2. For both common name is thiocyanate 2. But thiocyanate 2, KS for SCN, NCS means KN. So thiocyanato KS for SCN, thiocyanato KN for a NCS. KNCS for a KNCS. So neutral ligand special name, no special endings are there. The special names are water means aqua, but old name system is a aquo. Old system aquo we used to call it. If any other old book you are following, in that book they might have given a aquo. But that's now after 2004, the IUPAC name is changed to aqua. H2O is called as aqua. And CO, capital letter C, capital letter O is called carbonyl. Capital letter N, capital letter O is called as a nitrosyl. Capital letter C and small letter O is called as a metal of cobalt. Capital letter C, small letter O is a cobalt, name of the metal. Capital letter C and capital letter O is called as a carbonyl, it is a ligand. Then positive ligand, I already told you that it should be ended by IM. That is NO plus means nitrozonium. Negative ligands ends in O. Just I'm recalling the points of F minus, fluoride, fluorido, chlorido, Cl minus, chlorido, Br minus, bromido, I minus, iodido. NO2 minus, NO, ONO minus, both are nitrito, but this is called nitrito KN, this is called nitrito KO. NO3 minus, nitrato. SO4 2 minus, sulfate, sulfato, sulfite. SO3 2 minus is sulfito. OH minus, hydroxido. NH2 minus, amido. NH is called imine. So it is amido. And N, the whole power 3 minus is called nitrido, and N3 minus is called azido. Look at this difference between these two. This is called nitrido. Only one nitrogen here, three nitrogen with a one charge. It's called azido. Next, I already told you this O2 minus is called oxide, oxido. Then O2 2 minus peroxido, O2 minus superoxido, hydride ion is called hydrido, cyanide, this is isocyanide, both are called as commonly cyanido, cyanido, but this cyanido is a KC and this cyanido is a KN, and cyanate, this is called isocyanate, O comes cyanate, this is called without O cyanide, this is called cyanate, so cyanato. So both are called as commonly cyanato. That is what KK common name for cyanato, cyanato. But donor is O. Here donor is nitrogen. So it's called cyanato KO, cyanato KN. And next one is thiocyanate. This is isothiocyanate. So here SCN is called thiocyanate O. Isothiocyanate, E is replaced by O, thiocyanato. Both are called as a common name as thiocyanato. So what constantly we are calling as a KK, but here it is called KS and here it is called KN. Thiocyanato KS and for this thiocyanato KN. AS and KN as the donor atom. And CH3, COO minus is called acetato. H2O3, 2 minus, I mean thiosulfate, so thiosulfato, sulfide H2 minus, sulfido, carbonate CO3, 2 minus, carbonato, and chlorate ClO3 minus, chlorato, and oxalate COO minus, COO minus, we used to write a C2O4, 2 minus, oxalato. And OCrO3 2 minus chromate is called chromato. Next positive ligand end with IM, NO plus is called nitrazonium. NH2, I told you it is a fuel for a rocket. And is NH2, NH3 plus is called hydrazinium. NH2, NH2 is a hydrazine. Remember, hydrazine is the used in a fuel in rocket. So what we can easily, we can remember this hydrazinium, NO2 plus nitronium. Neutral ligand with the special names. And also this CH3NH2 is a methylamine, is a neutral ligand. Ethylene diamine is a neutral ligand. IUPAC name is ethane-1,2-diamine. Ethane-1,2-diamine. Shortly we can call it as a EN. EN is a neutral ligand. And pyridine, C6H5N is called, pyridine is a neutral ligand. The short form is PY. And thiourea is a neutral ligand. Thiourea, sulfur content. So TU is a short form of thiourea, is a neutral ligand. And 2-pyridine, so that is called dipyridyl. It is called DIPY. Dipyridyl is a neutral ligand. Phosphine is a neutral ligand. PH3. Phosphine is a neutral ligand. And few more exceptions of naming the neutral ligand. The old system I told you, water is called as aquo. Now after 2004, the IUPAC name is given as to call as aqua. For water, aqua is a neutral ligand. NH3 is a neutral ligand. Amine, double M should come. NO is a neutral ligand. Nitrozyl. CO is a neutral ligand, carbonyl. CS is a neutral ligand, thiocarbonyl. Don't get confused with the neutral ligand and the negative ligands. Methylamine is a neutral ligand, ethylene diamine is a neutral ligand, pyridine is a neutral ligand, thiourea is a neutral ligand, dipyridyl is a neutral ligand, phosphine is a neutral ligand. Water aqua is a neutral ligand, NH3 amine is a neutral ligand, nitrozyl is a neutral ligand, carbonyl is a neutral ligand, thiocarbon is a neutral ligand. So sit in one place and please by heart all the types of ligand, positive ligands, how to spell and what is the formula, negative ligands or ended with the O, chlorido, bromido, iodo, cyanido, like that. Please remember all the formulas and the exceptions of the name of the neutral ligand. Be thorough and then you come across to naming the compounds. Thank you, students.